today's gonna be a little quick review. I was got really bored, and I was like, hey, let's review my new frogman. I picked it up at my Target, so yeah. I was like, you know, I'm gonna get a new action figure. I need one. Sorely need one. Also, yes, I'll be working on that trailer for you guys. Don't worry, that trailer's gonna come in soon. Soon, I promise y'all. What else was I gonna say? Oh, also that I have, that there's gonna be, by the end of this time, there's gonna be a video uploaded for Frogman. So if you're ready to see that, if you have not seen that, you should go watch it right now before you watch me unbox this. Or if you like the unboxing, they like the star motion. I'm cool with that. I'm open to suggestions for people. Well, that being said, let's look at the box. So it's odd. When I picked this up, like, it had no type of, like, writing out there. I thought it'd be cool. I like the legend sign. Like, how it's, like, Frogman, but, like, kind of faded. Oh, you can't see it. It's kind of, like, faded, but it says Marvel Frogman. And I like the Marvel sign. Hasbro. And I like the, I like this. But, like, mine, I had it, and it broke. Like, I went to go open it. It broke on me as I opened it, so sorry about the laughter in the background. It's very loud. Yeah, I have the Peter B. Parker. You saw that in one of my trailers, and I have it comes with a Stiltman body mold and everything. Another sign of Frogman, and the back has nothing. It's unreadable, and there's a bio for him. If you guys want to read it right now, hold on. If you want to read it right now, go ahead and read it. Well, that being said, let's look at Frogman. Now here is Frogman out of the packaging. It comes with a lot of, it doesn't come with a lot, it's kind of like low on accessories. It comes with the Build-A-Figure piece and other stuff. But I'll go over articulation after we look at the accessories, so we're going to do a quick look at that. His accessories, I dig the accessories look, they're pretty cool looking. I thought that he would come with a gun, but I was like, no, they can't hold guns. Well, enough about the accessories. Let's take a look at the articulation of Frogman, the design. And let's look at the Frogman over here. So we're gonna do the articulation first, then we'll look at the painting. So for the Frogman, he can move his head up and down, side to side motion. I would dig that part for this guy. And then he has the 90, no. He does not go past 90, which is a problem, which I get it. He's a fat figure. And then, yeah, does not go past 90. Flippers, I like the flipper thing. They go pretty back, I guess. And then if you're into kicking his butt, like, yeah, let's try it. Can't kick his own. There he is, he kicked his butt. Barely. Oh my, he can barely kick it. Come on, kick it, kick it. Ah, you got it. Boot rotation. I think you should heat yours up. Like, I have not heat mine up, and it's, like, very low in rotation. Thigh cut, where it can move. Yeah, and then it goes up and down the arms. Yep, the arms move up and down. I like it. Let's look at the painting on this guy real quick. So I like how they have a mask, and it's like, so right now it looks kind of dark. It's not dark looking. It's pretty, it's actually pretty light looking. It's like a light looking frog. So on the camera, it looks kind of dark. It looks darker. Looks like a darker green. I like this guy a lot because Frogman used to be like one of my favorite guys from Marvel. Like, I liked him as a Daredevil villain. I never really read Daredevil. But I will say that reading Spider-Man comics, that this is a goofy character. Like, he's pretty goofy. Like, if you, like, look, hold on, let me zoom in real quick. If you look into his mouth, you can see that there's, like, eyes are peering out. It's not up there. So, like, that's what I like about this guy. Like, they don't make him look too scary so, like, other people can buy them and stuff. Like, it's pretty cool using this guy. Like, you can go on any part of your shelf. You can go on your Avengers shelf, Daredevil shelf if you want to be a bad guy. But he's also a good guy. Like, I like using him as a bad guy for, like, some clips. And then other clips, I like using him as a good guy, like working with the Avengers and everything. I like that whole stick about him. Well, let's do a size comparison real quick. Next to the body mold that he shares, Dr. Octopus. I like how he has the same type of thing right there going on. So, yeah. There he is next to his little friend. His shared body mode person. He is next to the Marvel Legends Classic Spider-Man. Yes, guys. I finally got my own Classic Spider-Man. Forget Negative Zone Spider-Man. Classic! I was, like, stoked that I found out I got my Classic Spider-Man. I was, like, waiting, like, rummaging through the mail, like, oh, Classic Spider-Man, where is he? So, I read the Deadpool comics recently. Deadpool and Spider-Man comics. Like, it's, like, inappropriate, but at the same time, it's kind of not. So, like, if you want a good read, I recommend you read that book for yourself. Because I really liked reading that book. It was pretty cool to me. So, that's the reason why I got him. Spider-Man, so yeah. I'm gonna do a little quick review on him later, because it's like a long one, because he's like, oh, I got my classic. See, I got my classic other figures, but Spider-Man? No. Never got that. I was so worried about getting the Super Suits before I got Classic. So I wanted a comic book, like, implication, like, so, like, if Negative Zone guy, Mr. Negative touches, Spider-Man, like, he can turn into Negative Zone Spider-Man, and then, like, my Spider-Man, that Spider-Man from, like, the normal Earth can, like, fight Miles Morales and stuff, do a lot of other stuff, and then I can do a lot of more Sinister Six stuff, so, like, that's pretty cool. Yep, it's pretty cool having those guys. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this review today, guys. So, yeah, be on the lookout for those action figures. Like, just be on the lookout. If you're into action figures, I recommend you go buy this guy. He's at Target for only, like, $20. It's not that bad of a price for this guy. And then, if you would like to buy Marvel Legends Spider-Man action figures, go check out eBay. That's where I got mine. Doesn't come with a box. It's real. They have the big time suit. They have the symbiote suit, and they have that one. I was psyched to get that. So yeah, I had Pizza Spider-Man Classic. Yeah. See, like, there's other people. There's other things you guys can do to get your action figures all put up. I'll do a tutorial on some of the things I use to make stop motions. Like, I'm gonna use my old, like, storage unit from Tech Decks, and I'm gonna use for, like, a battle with a Agent and Captain America pretty soon. I'll do that tutorial actually today. I will show you how to do that. And then I will show you guys how to make a stop motion. So that will be coming soon right after this video. I'm going to start posting a lot recently. School's almost over, so summer I'm going to be posting a lot most likely. So yeah. Be on the lookout for me posting a lot of stuff. It'll be a fun couple of weeks, so. Be a fun little couple. Also, do it in a message me on, like, comment what's your favorite, who you want me to review next. Because I have Deathlok. I have a lot of action figures I can review for you guys. Because I have, just tell me and I'll review, like, a quick one. I'll do, like, a quickie run on it. Like, I got the Scorpion. I got Rike Python. I got some action figures that you guys want me to review and talk about. I will do that for you guys. But all that being said, see you guys. It's been cool. Stay, like, really chill. Watch Spider-Man. Watch some TV. I don't care. Do whatever you guys want. And just be on the lookout for those stop motions and the tutorial. I'll see you guys next time. It's been Black Spider-Man on Super Reviews. I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.